Will Auckland ever get light rail? That's the question after the coalition government scrapped the Labor legacy project, leaving some in the business community disappointed. More than $200 million had already gone into the transport plan. Corazon Miller reports.
It's long past the morning rush hour, but an endless stream of traffic continues along Auckland's Dominion Road.
Got a problem in Auckland with transport and people spending a long time in queues trying to get to work and that sort of thing, and you need an efficient system.
Light rail was meant to be the answer, connecting the city from north to south.
We were looking forward to seeing progress in public transport, seeing progress towards our shared climate goals.
But after years of consultation and multiple proposals, the coalition government scrapped light rail outright, and there's no alternative.
The decision's also costly for staff who'll soon be out of work. Auckland Light Rail confirmed it had 22 permanent employees working on the project who'll all be made redundant.
Well, the government, as part of a 100-day plan, committed to cancelling Auckland Light Rail. It's a project that's gone nowhere despite hundreds of millions of dollars of taxpayers' money being spent on it. And we want to actually get on and deliver the transport projects that Aucklanders need.
For National, that's getting the City Rail Link finished, along with upgraded roads and more busways. Some have welcomed the decision.
Public transport, I mean, it's something that we have to live with, and it's something that we need more of, but it just needs to be done in a more managed way, I feel.
But public transport advocates say National's plan won't cut it.
A lot of their priorities are around building more roads, and that's not going to help address congestion issues or improve access around Auckland.
He blames Labor in part for the project's failure, saying the former government spent too much time consulting rather than doing.
It would be foolhardy to go straight into an infrastructure project without doing the necessary checks and balances, and some things do take time.
Local businesses frustrated that after all that time waiting, there's nothing to show.
What we want is certainty for our future. We welcome, even at the cost of disruption, the kind of investment that a rapid transit system requires.
As long as it makes for a better connected community. Corazon Miller, One News.